Ryan, check this out. I was maintaining the system. And then I decided to unhook the cells. And then the system was still maintaining. And it's like, what's going on? Then I was like, oh man. One of the problems I had a year ago when testing the system on 12-volt is I would go and I would put a coil and a capacitor on the 12-volt and I'd do a benchmark with a light on it. And it would drain at a certain rate. And then when I took the device off, I measured and I still had the same rate as if it had no effect. Now I was testing it all day and the next day, and then the battery was dead. So I charged it. And then I did the same test over and it didn't succeed. And then one day I charged it and I said, I'm going to do a benchmark of just the battery and the light. And then I saw a measurement and it was going down faster. I was like, hey, what's going on here? Then I put the device on it and then it started going down slow. And then I took the device off of it and then it was still slow as if the device was on it. So then I figured, hey, this device has an effect on the battery, which continues its effect. From that moment on, every test I did with the right device had success. And if the device wasn't good, it didn't work. I just followed the protocol. It seemed weird, but that's how it is. Now, if I would have gave up the first day, second day, third day, because I didn't do the protocol, I didn't know it, nobody had invented it yet, then I would have quit. And I would have said, this thing doesn't work. I explained this last year. Same thing's happening here. Now I'm getting a drain, okay? It's draining on me so fast. Then I'm not maintaining it the way I was before. So I'm going to replug my cells. I'm going to plug it on the coil that's pulsing. And then it's going to the light. So I have it plugged right out of the coil. And then I'm going to plug. I have it plugged here, which is my negative. It's going in the cells, down here in parallel, and they're going in series in this thing here, and then it's going back from minus to plus. So basically, it's coming out plus from the buck converter. You can watch the video I made before today. Made another one today. 964. 963. Now, let's see if everything's running well in place. Theoretically, if I'm right, it's going to balance itself. It's going to stop going down. Okay, I'm lighting up this light here. And look at this here. That's right. Going down. Yeah. Okay. Let's wait. Is that all right? I get a feeling already that it's slower than it should. Time will tell now. So basically, I explained the setup I have here in the previous video. Just look at the dates and find the one that I posted today. Actually, I posted a few of them, but there's one that you'll see. It's about this device. It's still going down. Now, I got my palsy going on. Oh, I added this buck converter and this device right now. On the output of this is going to a transistor flickering, going to the coil, coming back to the light going back to the boost converter. And this is plugged directly on the boost converter, but it should be plugged here on this. Here. Yeah. Okay, so let me unhook at least this little puppy here. So to have the same same load I had before. That created a big draw to light up this new device that I'm going to be playing with. But this is going back up. So basically, this one, if I want to plug it, I have to plug it on the same circuit that I'm plugging the light here. And maybe I'm going to have to put a capacitor. But I have to put the right capacitor. Going back up. So this is good. I like this. So my theory was right. My theory was right. Because this is going to balance. That's what word balances. But when it goes like this, I'm pretty much sure. Or it's going to self-charge like it did a bit before. It was a bit self-charging like this. So we'll see. If this is the case, let me explain you this magic. These cells will not only maintain your device, but you could take it off it, bring it to another set of batteries, put it on it, and it will condition the batteries. You'll take it off and it'll still have an effect. You're going to be able to go at your friend's house which has solar panels, plugging it on his device, and hopefully the solar panel will not restore the battery, but that could happen. If that happens, there's a way to flicker again with a transistor to pump it back. Basically, there's always a way. There's a way. 9.70. Guys, it's difficult to describe when we live through this. This is not just about devices. This is about a lot of things. This technology and the way to look at it is the future. And it is the veil that has been lifted. As you can see by the light itself, it's not a normal exactly phenomenon that's going on. As you can see, the battery is self-charging. And that charger is not on, as you can see right here. Oops. Very nice. Okay. That's a great thing. This is amazing news. If I take off the cell right now, once it's balanced, when I take off the cell, it's going to stay balanced. And then I'm going to put the charger on for 5 minutes. You'll see it won't be maintaining anymore. I'll put the cells back on. It'll be maintaining. It's amazing. Isn't it amazing? I mean, really. Anyway, guys, I've been working hard on this, man. You gotta help me share this to everybody. Please, out there, if somebody really has the will to want to help me to do this, some financing so I could make a big device, something to drive a car. Come on, please. I need big capacitors. I need expensive batteries, and I'm going to make a car for peanuts. It's going to cost peanuts compared to what it costs. 20 times less. For $2,000, I'm going to have a whole battery pack and a motor probably to go with it. And self-maintaining. So come on, guys. You're just asking for a few $1,000s here to get the first project really going. All the money goes to the material. Look, the work is paying off here, okay? Everybody that helped. The names, the list is long, man. You know, Michelle, Christine, Caesar, Jacob, Gary, Claus, Francois, are all people that, Bernal, all people that are $10, $100, $300, you know, they all put it on the table and they saw the results from it. I am not a bullshitter. I do things the right way, and I will not mess this up. So back me up, because I got your back. I did not sell out, and I will not sell out, but I need you guys to help me out. All this material, it may look nice, but it doesn't feed me on the table, it doesn't pay my rent, and it doesn't do all these things. So even if you give me money, it's all going to be materials, right? And if somebody wants to give it to me personally, well, you're welcome, because I don't have a bed, and I need a bed. And before I spend on the bed, I'm going to spend on this stuff. So that's how I am. Sorry for asking, but basically I'm giving, and I'm not asking for the world here, just participation. Share the video. All the form that you can help, come in the Zoom meetings on Wednesdays, 3 p.m. Eastern Central Time, U.S., Canada, Montreal time. And share with us, participate, come teach us what you think we need to learn. And together we can make this happen. I'm a bit surprised that it's still going up. It's supposed to be maintaining, not going up. I'd probably be maintaining around this area, though. I would like it to go to 7.8 and maintain there. Exactly there. Now, by playing around the way with I did, and I drained it a bit, it should, this number correspond as if there were no loss apart from the loss that I created when I plugged the battery charger and then unhooked it. Remember, when you plug a charger and you charge a battery, it resets the electrons into a more chaotic state. And when you plug these devices on, it restructures the electrons in a more superconductive state. Don't ask me exactly how it does that, but my observation confirmed this, my friends. I am so proud to you. I'm so proud to be able to tell you this. I'm really proud. I put in at least close to seven, if I calculate about, I think it's about 5,000 hours this year, 16 hours a day, 7 days a week, trying to help everybody out. So I'm going to continue doing this. This is my passion. Even if you don't give me help, I will help myself, because I'm already helping myself. If I tell you all I have in front of me, you wouldn't believe me. But let me give you this little hint. Monatomic gold, the food of the gods, the food of the light body. Monatomic silver, copper, are all in this. These are also healing elements, so the field is actually ideal for us. I'm not going to play no magic tricks right now, but let me say this. We are entering the golden age of light, and together we could do it right. Think peacefully. Think about us being able to create communities, which is free. Free in the sense that I don't get paid to do this, but we get results, and together we build a city, communities all around the world of truthfulness, compassion, based on real good stuff. No religion, just pure understanding through knowledge, through all its perceptions, including religions, but that would be more like on the specific research based to better understand how to better practice meditation and all sorts of cultivation to enhance yourself. I am maintaining it at the number that I am so proud. This is 100% accuracy in my knowledge of this battery. This is so important. I want to kiss you guys. Can you believe how much love we really have for each other? And when we live joy, we could kiss everybody. We want to just love everybody. So that's real magic of having this, because the feel of it right now is like a living entity. It has Taurus around it, like an aura. And this aura is connected to the source energy, etheric energies, and the frequencies that this device can tap into. Just like our bodies tap into this, this device taps into it. And just like if I had a human being beside me, his heat and his exchange of openness, if he'd be like a master, I'd feel good. Well, this field is a type of mastery. So because a master creates this field around him, and it's so balanced that it balances everything out. And there's nothing in the universe that this energy cannot balance out, because it is the energy that created it in the first place. This is really profound, guys. This is so profound, we could change the world with this knowledge. I'm getting a bit overwhelmed. My emotions want to express so many things at once. So I'm going to close the video because I'm filled with emotions right now. I'm filled with wanting to share something incredible. So just know by my tone of voice and my emotions, what I'm trying and what I'm conveying, it's pure goodness. I can't describe it right now. When it happens, you feel the field also doing it to you. It's quite amazing, because the unbalanced fields of my own emotional state of wanting so much to share and all that the beauty that I know in the universe through the cultivation practice, through understanding of thousands of different perspectives, because I'm dealing with strange people and entities or whatever, one and the same, I believe. Mr. And Mr. Pleiadian, Mr. Yusan, whoops, Yusan is not in English, but others are. Sorry about that one, channel slipped out. Now, feeling the shoes, not to worry, because everybody's heart is in the right place. So, peace to all of you. Those of beings that play the good game, but they're manipulating, or I have to say that it's not the right thing what you do, and it seems that some races cannot surpass themselves, and if it's the case, well, it's too bad, because you're gonna. It's going to be more difficult for you to adapt to what's going to be going on in our deprogramming of what all the BS corporations and agendas, groups, races, underground tech, shit you wouldn't believe. Now, this is shit I'm not believing, because the fucking thing's charging again. That means I got a headroom. And I got a lead that if I plug another converter, I need to plug it here on this light between the same poles and boost up the converter to light it up. Because if I go otherwise, the system will not maintain. Okay, so it's a totally new way, but it's a way that works. And I just wanna kiss you or smack you. I don't know what I wanna do, but I just here to say, man, God, man, this is destiny. Come and join us, please. Make these devices, prove it to yourself. Come ask me questions. I'm here to face the truth, and the truth I will face. So let's face the truth together and make the leap of advancement together. Please donate of your time. Please donate of your knowledge. Please donate of all form of abundance that you have to share. AB land, opportunities for us to go build what we want to build, and build these devices for mankind. Now, before people try to patent my stuff and make the money off of it, because I'm not selling out, I need you guys to fucking back me up here. We need to back up, or else it's not going to work. So please, I'm counting on you. I'm not counting on you. Humanity actually is. To be honest with you guys, this is, I don't have no choice here to do what I have to do, because I have it. I know it. I tell you it. I shared it. I'll share it. I'll design it. I'll draw it. I'll do everything that I need to be done for you guys to grow. I'm not bullshitting you. I already did it. And it's not about I. It's about us now. It's about you recognizing yourself and what I'm doing. It's about we being one. The I in me is the I in you. The I use is the I you are. How can I say this so you never judge me for me saying I am, you are, I am that I am, is the life force giving us the opportunity to destinize our paths into one. Friendship, honor, truth, caring, connecting, knowing, understanding, forgiving. Peace fulfilling. I need to turn that one with the peace. So peace, guys. And thank you. You know who I'm talking to. All of you that deserve for me to say thank you. Thank you to all of you.